Hey guys, Vonk here. In a recent video, we pointed out Melee's efforts to introduce villains to the Smash roster featuring Bowser, Ganondorf, and Mewtwo, depending on what part of Pokemon lore you're judging by. Brawl continued this effort, adding Wolf, Wario, and two antagonistic reps from Sakurai's Kirby franchise. Those were the incredibly broken Meta Knight and the lovable bulbous penguin King Dedede. In Brawl, Dedede was a very strong competitive choice. The low hitstun and therefore limited combos in Brawl made it slightly easier to exist as a big body, and Dedede had an incredible chain grab that obliterated most matchups. The Jolly King would have much less luck in Smash 4, however. Chain grabs were removed universally, and Dedede also lost his quick back air in favor of a slow hammer swing. His side special replaced Waddle Dees with Gordos exclusively, although they were toned down from Brawl's explosive RNG Gordos. And this is pretty much the same King Dedede we see in Smash Ultimate. He's slow, giant combo food for most top tiers, and is typically ranked towards the bottom of the cast. Some players consider him a sleeper mid-tier with his Gordo traps and command grab mix-ups, but no matter how you look at it, Dedede is unviable in competitive Ultimate. So, for our question of the day, how would you fix King Dedede? We polled all of you to see what suggestions you choose, so stay tuned to see if yours made the cut. Real quick, let's talk about the benefits of ProGuides.com. If you're still losing to that online Dedede player, or if you want to get better with the character yourself, our site has everything you need. Hit up a pro coach to train you using our InstaPro platform, check out an in-depth character guide, or even tune into a live class where you can play with the pros. So, what makes King Dedede so bad? He actually has a lot of strong options, so what's holding him back? At this point, there's a common trend developing among so many low tiers we'd like to fix. Dedede is slow. Like, really slow. He has a bottom 15 run speed for starters, but in the air, Dedede is the slowest character in the game. His airspeed is beyond terrible, and his acceleration is pretty bad too. The developers perhaps thought this was compensated for by his multiple jumps, but it certainly isn't. Despite having a bunch of mid-air jumps, they don't travel very high and move sluggishly, more so letting him hover than really gain much height. They're still good for mixing up landings, but giant up-airs like Palutena's could not give two Waddle Dees about a Dedede jumping to avoid them. His fall speed is at least very fast, but this leads him to get comboed more than it helps him land. Sadly, it isn't just King Dedede's movement that's slow. His frame data is generally awful as well. Besides for his frame 7 Nair, all of his aerials are frame 10 or higher. While the hammer does make them disjointed, Dedede's stubby arms, or wings, swing the hammer very close to his body, letting most sword characters outrange him nevertheless. These aerials, again with the exception of Nair, have lots of landing lag too, and are pretty unsafe on shield in a game where, like, everything is safe on shield. Even though his Nair is quite good, it has poor range and no disjoints, so Dedede has to get right into you to hit with it, and that's naturally very difficult for a character with such terrible airspeed. Being slow in every way is enough to make most characters unviable, but some, like Byleth, can still work around this. Unfortunately, Dedede is not just slow, he's slow and massive. As we've discussed in our other videos, having a large hurtbox is generally a very bad trait. It makes a character easier to hit in all aspects of gameplay. Big bodies like Bowser and Charizard at least have quick movement to lug their gigantic bodies out of harm's way, but Dedede lacks that luxury. He'll rely on Gordos and mix-ups just to move around without getting swatted, and in disadvantage, he has almost nothing to deal with an opponent right near him. Those Gordos are pretty useful though. Dedede can use Gordos to cover his approach, cover ledge options, help him land, and edgeguard. They'd be an amazing tool if they weren't such big fans of tennis. Yes, the Gordos can be knocked back at Dedede by any attack dealing 2% or more. Dedede can still knock them back himself afterwards, but the need for awareness of this severely guts the potential of Gordos for controlling a situation. Notably, characters with constant projectile spam will make it almost impossible for Dedede to get a Gordo out effectively. Other slow big bodies like Ganondorf and Incineroar at least attempt to compensate for their glaring weaknesses with good combos and/or KO power. Dedede, not so much. His back air, dash attack, and smash attacks are quite strong, but they're incredibly slow and don't have the ridiculous range of Ganondorf's when it comes to smashes. He lacks potent kill throws and has a mediocre combo game in general, with only a few confirms from throws and neutral air. Also, unlike Ganondorf, his dash attack is super slow, so coupled with his sluggish ground speed, DDD can't do much in the way of whiff punishing. His few saving graces, besides for Gordo ledge traps, are his incredible survivability and decent recovery. King Dedede is the fourth heaviest character in the game, and also a very fast faller with high gravity, making him survive vertical kills incredibly late. His up special travels very high, and also has windows of super armor to protect him from most edgeguards. Alright, so we've established Dedede as a super slow big body with poor frame data, who's forced to rely on mix-ups and traps to get much of anything done. How can we fix him? Let's see what you had to say. Make sure to subscribe here to our YouTube channel right now so you can catch our poll for future How to Fix videos. So, first up, DidDidDementio said, giving a buff to Gordo that makes it so that you can't hit it back would be huge. Also, slightly increasing his airspeed would do wonders for him. We think this is right on the money. Even in its current state, Gordo is most likely DDD's best tool. It allows him to compensate for his lack of mobility by controlling a large space. If opponents couldn't hit this move back, DDD could actually play the way he wants to, putting up a constant wall like Piranha Plant does and covering the options that impatient opponents use to approach around it. Gordo still disappears on shield, so this wouldn't make him broken, it would just let him maximize his existing playstyle. An airspeed buff is more generalized, but boy would it help. When DDD jumps, it almost feels like he's trapped in an elevator where he can only move up or down, and this makes it really unreliable for him to space his already slow, unsafe aerials. Next, Michael Thompson said, make some of his moves have less startup or end lag, and buff down B cause it's useless. Also give him some more mid-percent combos, just not too many or he'll be busted. More great points! Like we explained, it isn't just DDD's movement that's slow. He could really use some speed buffs on aerials like fair and back air, especially since they aren't as huge as many sword aerials anyway. Reducing landing lag would be great too, so DDD could actually land safely with aerials besides Nair, like a normal character. Additional combos would be great too. It would actually be interesting if Gordo was repurposed to be more of a combo tool, with a different angle and lower knockback. It doesn't kill until really high percents anyway, and it would be much easier for him to find combos off of a Gordo rather than grab, which is hard for him to land. At the same time, if his Gordo was made to not get launched back at him, he'd be better at forcing opponents into shield, where a grab combo buff could be more useful. Aditya Karnikar echoes a few previous suggestions and adds these. Give him less startup and end lag on his F smash, give down tilt invincibility so it becomes a get out of jail free card, give him a crouch stun hitbox which will stun players, give inhale the ability to heal as well as reflect, and make up air kill earlier. For starters, the F smash buff could be bigger than you might think. If DDD had a forward smash that worked anything like Ganondorf's, he'd be able to cheese early kills and trap landings with it more easily. Giving down tilt intangibility would be really interesting. If this sounds too broken for DDD, keep in mind that Cloud's down tilt was intangible in Smash 4. His down tilt is already pretty disjointed, but only hits in a small area in front of him. Intangibility would make it better as already DDD's best grounded get off me option, and it would help him trap landings as well. The crouch stun idea sounds ridiculous, but there are ways this could be implemented. The hitbox could be very small or very slow, perhaps only hitting if Dedede's body actually makes contact with the opponent. It might just end up as a meme option, but adding to the already coolest crouch animation in the game would be pretty neat. Inhale healing is something that other characters already have, so it would be a natural fit for Dedede. Officially, it's stated that Dedede can't copy abilities like Kirby because he's, and I quote, already perfect. But he can still eat things, right? If not, I've got some questions for that belly. Lastly, up air could, and probably should, kill earlier. It isn't exactly weak, but it has a wide DI angle, so you can get sent out really diagonally. A simple narrowing of this angle would make up air a better kill move, or increasing his air acceleration would allow him to drift more ambiguously, making DI cross-ups on up air more effective. As with many lower tier characters, King Dedede is kind of trapped in an archetype that keeps him from getting too good without a huge redesign. But the Gordo buffs we mentioned, along with some speed increases, would make him much better at what he already does. It would also be great if he had his Brawl back air back, but nothing short of the chain grabs from that game will make him top tier. Hey guys, Bonk again. And what do you think? Let us know in the comments, and be sure to subscribe for more from Pro Guides. Thanks for watching, guys.